Good morning everyone, hope you all are good. This is Nilanj Nabira, your art teacher, and today we will be working on spatula painting. Material required for the same are In the first step, I am taking cobalt blue and white and trying to apply it on the canvas board on a certain direction, which is the left to right, and I'm going to follow all on the same board. Maybe the color variation I can do, some places I can add little more white and some with a darker tone, so that I will be deciding. And yeah, there are two options: either you can mix the color on the same palette, or it will automatically mix on the canvas board, so that you can do by yourself. Suppose the lower section of the canvas, I am just trying to keep it a little lighter tone, maybe a white, a very light hint of blue, and the top portion maybe a little more darker where I think that it is required. So these variations you can do by yourself. Once you have done the entire canvas, you will get some kind of texture. As much as thicker the color is, it will give you a texture, and if you're following it in a certain way, so you will be getting it more clearly. So you can see it a little closely. Before moving to the next step, you have to make this base dry. Just wait for that and then start with the next work. Now the base is dry, I'm gonna work with white and yellow to create some tulip flowers, and I'm using both the colors on my spatula and trying to create it in a form of a bud shape. So you have to hold that spatula and create that, and the direction can be varied in different ways, because you're trying to create or give it a shape of a flower. Now each time when you're just applying the color, it is quite thicker. So in texture or a spatula painting, you have to take those colors in a very thicker consistency, then only you will able to apply it on that surface, and that kind of texture is also visible. So each time you need to take the color from the palette, and by pressing that spatula, you will get that wider or the broader shape. You can apply it from the tip, but when you need to create that shape or make it wider, you need to press that spatula from the reverse side. Now when I'm making each bud or flower, I am trying to get that shape in a certain way, and even if I have to rectify or add that second layer of white, I have to maintain that too. If it goes little wrong, we can have a scope of retouching in the background or on the main object. Here I am adding that yellow and blue tone which I have already used for that green stem, and now I am just using the edge of that spatula, because I need those stems to be a little thinner, so I don't need too much wider space. So here I am using only the edges of that spatula. Now for the leaves which I'm gonna create, I'm gonna use that spatula in a little wider form. So I'm gonna press it at the end when I'm trying to remove the spatula from the canvas. So for creating something wider, you can press that and use the reverse color on the spatula. Once you have done with that lighter color of the green, for the depth you can mix that green with little bit of blue or black to create the darker tone. So these retouch-ups can be done at any point of time when you think it's required. even on the background, if some extra color is there, you can use the same white or blue to create or to remove that extra color. So on the edges of that canvas, I'm just using a white tone and a wider spatula just to create the sides little lighter and the center a bit darker. I have used a bit of mild color, so it's your choice how you want to end up or finish up that work. Hope you have understood the technique and will definitely try. Instead of spatula, if you have metal scale or ice cream sticks, you can work with that too. It will give you a similar kind of impression. Thank you for watching.